Tech Tools gave me an extra set of knives, so I thought I'd investigate what happens when you run a staple through there. And for comparison, I'll also do this on my cheap Mastercraft planer. I only want a single little controlled nick, so I'm gonna cut this off. So I just have a tiny piece of metal still in there. I'll adjust it so that it takes off about 1/16th of an inch. And I'm going to run it through near the edge just so I don't completely ruin the knives. So the wood is nice and smooth here, and right where the staple is, we have this ridge that starts, and it's a pretty good sized nick. Very narrow, but pretty deep. So let's check this with a dial indicator. And as I move that wood across, that needle goes up by more than 5 thou, or more than 0.1 millimeter, just from that one staple that I cut through. And now, with another piece of wood, I'll run the same test on my Mastercraft planer, which unfortunately I don't have spare knives for. And we have a very similar result here. Let's check the height of this nick. I get about 6 thou worth of deflection, maybe 7. So if anything, the knives on the Mastercraft planer got more nick than on the DeWalt. Aside from staples, one of the worst things you can run through a planer is any sort of paint. So that's what I'll try next. Well, I can't tell that the wood is any less smooth on one end or the other. And I followed up with another piece of wood, and I really can't tell where the damaged part of the knives would be. So, this little bit of paint did not significantly damage it yet. So, I'll try my other two pieces as well. So, I got my workpiece stuck, and what happened is my other workpiece got in here at an angle like this, and then the other workpiece got stuck underneath it, and nothing would go. This is a known frustration with a DeWalt planer. And I ran this piece afterwards, and once again, I really can't tell where I ran the painted stuff through. So, this amount of paint, or at least for my acrylic paint, appears to be okay. I also ran a piece of softwood through afterwards, and again, I can't tell where the knives would have been damaged, although I just noticed there's another nick that I've put into the knives already somewhere else. Also, interestingly, you can see a lot of little indentations all around here. I'm guessing those are from chips that got caught underneath the knives. Now, I had been wondering if some of these chips getting caught between the knives and the wood were caused by not having a big enough hose on the back. So I switched to a 4-inch hose, which goes to my big dust collector, but even there, I'm finding I have a bit of back pressure in there because if I turn on the big dust collector, this is only a dryer hose, so now the hose is under vacuum and it's pulled together, but if I turn on the planer, you can see the hose is under a lot of pressure, so this puts out a lot more air. And this thing normally sucks up. But with this hose on there on a big dust collector, I now no longer get any chips left on the table. So clearly, my 2-inch hose was just not adequate for this one. So I've been looking very closely at some of the plain wood, and you can see all kinds of little divots in the wood. And I think that is from shavings getting caught underneath the knives, and this was planing 3/32 of an inch off on the DeWalt. But experimenting some more, this is the same kind of wood, and here I only planed off 1/32 of an inch, that's less than a millimeter, and there's much less of that happening. And then I also repeated that same experiment using the Mastercraft planer, and it does worse than the DeWalt. But again, if I plane off just a tiny bit on the Mastercraft, then there's much less of that happening. Ignore some of these streaks, like here, that's other damage to the knives. There's much less of that divoting happening if I just set the feed rate to the slow speed on the DeWalt, but then it feeds half as fast, and what I could do instead is just take two shallow passes instead of one deep one. I've also been experimenting with difficult grains, so this is planing 3/32 of an inch on the DeWalt and on the Mastercraft, and aside from the divoting, you can see a little bit of tear out right here and here and here. Overall, the Mastercraft planer does slightly worse. Let's try that again with a really shallow pass. And here's a result from that. Less divoting because it's a shallow pass, but we're still getting a little bit of tear out. Again, the Mastercraft planer is slightly worse. And this is the result from the slow speed on the DeWalt, and I don't see any more tear out. There is a bit of ridging because I've damaged the knives already a bit, but it seems to, for the most part, at least with this only lightly figured wood, solve the tear out problem. And that last sample actually run with dust collection disconnected because my big dust collector and the 4-inch hose still restrict the airflow coming out of here because that hose gets quite pressurized and I was still getting some divoting from shaving. So with the dust collection disconnected, that seems to make that much better. Looking inside the opening here, you can see the impeller is two-sided. The right side is for air from chip collection and the left side is air from the motor, and I think this is a design flaw in the DeWalt because they're also blowing the motor cooling air out here, which makes for even more air coming out, which not all dust collection is able to swallow. Also, if airflow is restricted because the hose or the filter gets plugged up, the cooling airflow from the motor is also restricted. On pretty much any planer, you can shift the knives to the side a little bit so that the nicks in the knives are misaligned. So I did this on the DeWalt, and this here is where the staple nick is, so it hardly shows up at all. By contrast, I haven't done this on the Mastercraft, and this is the ridge that's left by the staple nick on that one, so a world of a difference by shifting the knives.